Yeah, very overcast day, humid. I would think about 24, 25 degrees. Could be 6, 26. Now you can see this rice seedling over here coming on nicely. That's about ready nearly to be planted out. So I would think this next week they'll start with that. So here's little Ella waiting for me. That's unusual. Yeah, been quite a bit of rainfall this last 12, 14 hours, hasn't there? What do you say, Ella? Yes. Yes, you're a good little dog, aren't you? Come on then. Come on. No, that's unusual. She's usually belting away. Well, down on poolside, I've only two with us because we've had a bit of an incident, which does happen now and again, but due to Michael's bloody lapse of memory. And I came down yesterday with Bobby, Rosie, Ash and Minnie, which I shouldn't have done. I shouldn't have brought Ash, because Ash flew at Minnie. Minnie's injured. She got a bad foot, she can't walk, so she's in the cage. And we've been to the vets and we've got everything we need for her and that. Also, Ash. Ash is in under medication. Friday, 3rd of June. And I've just crept down to the hobbled down to the bloody pond. And I've got our Minnie with us, who's hobbled down here also. Minnie's on the mend like, but she's not right yet. Hiya, Ronnie. No. Good girl. Good girl. You can see she's got a plaster on there, like. Mum changes it every day, twice a day. And she's getting there. But hey, any dog lovers, breeders especially, will know the controversy that goes on within the breeds. The odd fighting and that like. But now, there's Rosie and Bobby in. That's nice to see, isn't it? It's quite a hot day. And we've had Mim's mother here. And she's been raiding the gardens like for white turmeric, which is quite rare actually. But we happen to have a good supply of it. And normal turmeric and lemongrass and sugar cane. So I've took half a pickup full of bloody stuff away and took her to one of the local wats, where she's gonna stop with a friend or two and return in about a week. That's looking healthy. Leaves are looking very shiny. That's in a good state of affairs. But I think Mem's been putting a bit of liquid fertiliser on them. So they're gonna be healthy. Well, what are you doing down here, Michael? Feeding the fish, yeah, in a fashion. Yeah, this fruit, rotten fruits, they go in. They'll eat it, you watch. Right, I'll just knock this off for a second. Well, the majority of this stuff is overripe mango and a couple of bananas. So, and majority of it's gone down, but they're coming in, they're coming in. Yeah, see, there you go. Yeah. I tell you what, I saw some catfish yesterday, like, but poof, big size, like. Now, what are you two doing? What are you doing in there? What is it? Now, down there is where it runs through. So, but there's some activity going on, and I've got a feeling it's a bloody snake. I'm not sure. But they're all, I noticed Brad was down here the other day with Butter, the pair of them. Stuff needs trimming down here. There's a nice pineapple, not too far off. Not too far off. Now, you don't see Butter in the water very often, like. They just love being over this other side. And there's the whinge. Could you hear the whinge? There you go. That's all day, every day. Constantly hunting. Constantly looking for stuff. And that's what they're renowned for, this Thai Ridgeback breed, hunters. They're natural hunters. They have the good points, they have the bad points. And to tell you the truth, one or two, there's one or two little things over here with the Thais, with Ridgebacks, but see, they're original Thai dog, and some call them the royal dog, Thai royal dog. But I don't think there's any connection there, like, whether the royals have kept them, I don't know. But they're a good dog. They're not the easiest dog by a long way. They're very self-centered, they like to do their own thing, like, they're not good at taking orders. But if you train them right, yeah, I suppose they are trainable. But see, they do what we want when we call them, they come usually. But anything that's natural to them will take over. Now, obviously, Ash has come off heat because Bobby's not there. So, yeah. Right, come on then. Come on. Away. See if they follow. Hopefully. Come on now. Come on. Bobby. Come on. Ash. Come on. See, there you are. Did as I asked. So there you go.
Now then, these next clips following on. Michael's been playing around with a bit of new software. It's a new bit of editing suite. So just bear with us. I'm just getting the hang of it and experimenting with it. So if it's not to your liking, let me know. Okay.
Yeah, so what I'm about to tell you is, after 8 months of having Ash here now, we're tending to find this blue Ridgeback dog, can be quite aggressive. Certainly Ashes, and Ash comes with a very high pedigree. She's from Show Dog Champions. So, but it's just something about Blue Ridgebacks. They're completely different to Reds and Blacks. Structure and that, but anything to do with food. But see, this stemmed from the other day. I think I mentioned it on the last vlog that a walking catfish had got along the fence side on the neighbour's side, so it must have come out of his little fish tank he's got. And Minnie went down to get it, followed by Ash, but Minnie didn't like it, so she flew at Ash and gave her a little bit of a kicking like. But ever since then, a friend of mine said dogs never forget. Well, it hadn't been long and certainly Ash didn't forget. And ever since then, if Ash sees Minnie, she flies at her and can be quite nasty. So that's another lesson learnt. You know, you won't find this out. You won't find this out off other breeders. Why? Well, they're frightened you'll not buy. But we're not there for that. We are there to inform you about the breed and how we keep them. I don't want to hear all this shite about training your dogs and this, that and the other. The dogs are happy. Yeah, there's a problem. You've got to separate certain dogs at certain times. So that's another lesson learned. So mark my words, if you're gonna buy Blue Ridgebacks, just be noted that they can be quite aggressive. So there you go. At the moment, paid another vet's bill and the dogs are on the mend. Minnie's not quite walking yet, but she got a nasty attack on the leg. But see, the problem was they went into a sort of pack violence where Rosie had a go and Bobby had a go. And so it was quite nasty. But I finally got them separated and cooled down and took them to get sorted out. At the time, yesterday, Mem wasn't feeling too well and she slept most of the day, but like I've told her, too much working, knock it off, you know. So, right, we live and learn, don't we? There's another lesson learnt and we've passed it on to you. So, you know, any future people wanting to buy, careful with the blue ones. I'm probably going to get attacked by one or two breeders or vloggers, but don't care. We tell it how it is. So there you go, another lesson learned. Step out of the rain. Some information that I gave you about some of the aggression in the dogs of late. Mem was telling us yesterday when I went back to the house that on Facebook, the breeder we got bread, butter and mini from has been on warning people about aggression with some of the pups. And they've started fighting. And then apparently that set a bit of a trend off because he was getting messages back off other breeders to state that they too are experiencing quite a bit of violence within the litters. So, but we've always, all our litters, there's been a little bit of boisterousness and one or two have been quite nasty little attacks.
Naughty.
So I think we can officially put that down to the breed. and the characteristics of the breed. So yeah, just a little bit more added on information for you. Still down here, just a little add-on that we're gonna have a treat for tea tonight. What's that, Michael? KFC bargain bucket. No, obviously I'll share that with them, and then for dessert, durian fruit. If you go to the local markets and around this area, you pay a bloody fortune. But if you go to the bigger places and cities, you'll find it cheaper because there's more competition, isn't there? But yes, special treat tonight. And I would think Turian will be dying up a bit very shortly, like it's going to short supply. It's peaked its season.